children, welcome back to social studies tutorial. So students, as you know that we have completed our revision session. Now let's continue to the syllabus, that is, so here in today's session we are going to start a new chapter of civics, that is chapter 3, the union legislature, the parliament. So students, just first to recall the last chapter, the ideas and the ideals of the Indian constitution, where we have talked about like what exactly the constitution, and we have also talked about some of its key features. So while learning about the key features of Indian constitution, we have talked about the fundamental rights, fundamental duties, federal structure of government, where we have also talked about the parliamentary form of government. So yes students, that you have to connect this outcomes of the last chapter with this chapter. So what in a federal structure, we have seen that the India has a federal republic. Why it's so? Because there is government works at the different levels. So the government works at the central level, that is the union government, and the government also works at the state level, that is the state government. So students, what exactly there is the body that governs India at the center, that is the India's union legislative, that is known as the parliament. So students, that parliament has its two houses. It consists of the two houses, the Rajya Sabha, that is also known as Council of States, and the Lok Sabha, that is House of the People. So students, as you know that parliament is the highest law making body of the country. The members of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha are called members of parliament, and the parliament holds its session at Sansad Bhavan or Parliament House, that is located in New Delhi. So while talking about parliament, a question comes to our mind that why was the parliamentary form of government chosen, as we have also one of the we also had one more option, that is of the presidential form of government. So students, that is the only fact where we have to recall the federal structure of the government and the parliamentary form of government. So representational democracy can either adopt a parliamentary form of government or a presidential form of government. So in our country we have parliamentary form of government, as the executive is answerable to the legislature. Do you know what exactly executive and legislature? There are three organs of the government. These are the executive, the legislature, and the judiciary. So the executive is answerable to the legislature. If the executive loses the support of the majority in parliament, then it will have to resign. Whereas in a presidential form of government, the head of state, that is the president, who is directly elected by the people and hence wields great power. And the president heads the executive, and the executive is not answerable to the legislature. So what exactly, what it gives an idea that if we would have been chosen that presidential form of government, then it would give too much power in the hands of a single individual. So somehow it becomes a kind of dictatorship. So just to avoid the misuse of the power, we have chosen the parliamentary form of government, so that the each of the organ just monitor or control the working or the functioning of the other. As I told you that the executive is answerable to the legislature, and if the executive loses the support of the majority in parliament, it will have to resign. So just because of this fact, we have chosen parliamentary form of government. Students, this was the concept of parliament and the that why we have chosen the parliament form of a government. In our next session, we'll talk about Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. These are the two houses that, as we have learned in today's session, that the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha, these are the two houses of parliament. In our next session, till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.